So we spent watching and living a fandom for more than 3 years. There are 3 books and 4 movies, and we managed to hate a character for so long, and then she decides to write an entire book which is based on him. Welcome back to the channel, everyone. I hope you guys are doing absolutely fine. So the book, The Ballad of the Songbirds and Snakes, I've just finished reading. To start with the entire book review, first of all, if you have not watched, if you have not read the books as well as the movies of the entire The Hunger Games fandom, then this book is something which takes us back into time altogether when The Hunger Games were introduced, and it was around 65 years before the timeline that we get to see into the Hunger Games. So to start with, the writing style is very much similar to the books of the entire 3 books of the Hunger Games franchise, and it really isn't that much different with respect to all the 3 movies as well that we saw. Only one thing that I prominently thought about it was 70% of the book is very much slow. It was very much boring. And even the things which were very much important, or many of the suspense features were thrown very much abruptly and suddenly, and it were like just done with it. So I felt that only last 20% of the book is actually worth reading, because we get to know many things about what was actually happening throughout the book into the last 20%. So it is a very fast read according to me, but I really gave it very slow because I was really getting bored after reading like 5 to 10% of a part. So I was just giving it away, and I took a really long time to read the entire book. Talking about the characters, there are 2 main characters. First is the character of Snow, President Snow, when he was very young, and he was an 18-year-old kid, and he was being given as a mentor into the 10th Hunger Games, and the entire story, entire book has been based around him, that how he first was a mentor, and then everything happened into the arena, and then he was promoted to a peacekeeper. And then that story led him into what he was, what we saw into the Hunger Games and the further years, when he eventually became the president of Panem. Second main character is Lucy Gray. Again, she is a tribute from District 12, who again is the entire... she isn't the POV character. She is one of the tribute which is participating into the arena again as the Hunger Games, as again the very similar storyline. But only here she is one of that main feature of the entire book, where the story revolves around Snow basically, because they have shown this kind of romantic angle between them, between Snow and Lucy Gray, and eventually she understands what Snow is going through, and she realizes what he is going to become into. And the best part was about the ending, that she realizes how Snow is going to turn out, and her disappearance was really one of the great feature of the book, because because she ended the book in a way that it is still a mystery, her disappearance. And also she is one of the reason why Snow led on to the way that he eventually become what he is now. Another character is Sejanus. Again, he has played a very good role in as a mentor part when he was with Snow. But again, he was a part of the rebels. He was not really well aware and well agreed with the concept of the Hunger Games. And at a very early stage, he was in the same angle, in the same level with respect to Snow. But eventually, Snow realizes that he is not doing right, and at a part of mind he was always a part of a capital, and he always kind of supported the way things are at Panem, and the way things are which are ruled out into the Hunger Games. And he was trying to keep Sejanus out of that, keeping to him away from that, but when he eventually decides, and when he starts recording the Jabberjays, and eventually he sends it to Dr. Gall again, he that is the main me, that is the point where we get to know that definitely Snow is not who he is turning out to be. He turned out against his friend, and eventually he is going to become who we know he is. Another character is the Dr. Gold's character, which is a mastermind behind the Hunger Games. Because in the further in the Hunger Games trilogy, we get to know that what exactly could be done into an arena, the monkeys and all the other mutts which are released inside that. We get to see a lot of things, even Mockingjays, how they were how they came into existence from Jabberjays, and we get to know all that. Part which is really interesting. That part of book was definitely interesting, but again, she basically plants the seed into Snow's mind that how exactly these things are going to work out, and he realizes at that point when he submits his assignment to her, and based on that there she realizes, and from there she leads him to the role where he can actually become one of the cruel minds which who actually enjoys the Hunger Games. And Tigress, I was super surprised to go through this entire journey, and they are on really great terms, and because I was not really aware about because Tigress was shown in series in the movies for like very limited span. She just helps Katniss and her friends to stay into the basement, but the things none of those things were expected, that she could be so close to Snow in the entire in his entire childhood, and he just dumps her off. That is really again a mystery, and I would like to know your thoughts in the comment section about what could have happened that in that very end he is a president and she is just hiding there, and she is not really, because she even mentions a statement that she that her brother dumped her when she was not good enough. So that is really one of the curious point which I thought about the arena and games. Again, it is the 10th Hunger Games, so there is not too much of advancement with respect to the mutts. There are definitely drones which are there. There are definite cameras which is there inside the trees, which we even get to know even in the further days. But still, we get to see this timeline is still way ahead than us. What we are in 2020. Even the 10th Hunger Games are again in a very further timeline where the arena is basically not too much advanced to show that many like the clock or the mutants or the poisonous gas. All those things are not that much developed, but it is just in the premature stages of the arena. And the ending part, as I said, I enjoyed the book only for the last 20%. It was the whole 80% was too much repetitive, and it was very short story, and whatever things were thrown out to you, the important facts, those were like really thrown out, and abruptly they were done with it. So the last 20% was really good, and in the end I would just say that in the ending part of the book, the basic end that they did was they just brought back Snow again to the capital, and from then he moved on with his journey to become what he is today. And the thing again that they went all the way, that they wanted to explore outside the District 12th, that entire portion was really good. That was very much engaging enough that both of them lead out of District 12, that they wanted to settle outside. But again, while we are reading, we get to know Snow's point of view as well, that he is not 100% on board with this, but he just goes with his guts. And the entire romantic angle which has been played between Snow and Lucy Gray, I was not really that much convinced that is he really into her, or is it really going to take that way. But that part definitely proved everything, that Lucy Gray very much analyzed what his thoughts are going to be, or what he would eventually become, and she played very gracefully. But her mystery is definitely one of the biggest point in the entire book. And then eventually he took on the training. He went back, he was supposed to go back in District 2 for the further training, but eventually he came back and he again started experimenting into the capital. So this is how the book ends. There are a lot of points, a lot of things that leads to what he is now today. The final thoughts about this book would would be this book was really not that much necessary. Susan Collins could have played any different storyline, because when we go to the prequel, we expect to know things which are more about Hunger Games, which are more about the entire fandom of that, how had it origined. It would have been a great content if she would have shown the reason and how everything worked out between the capital and the district, and how the entire war thing happened, and why the Hunger Games were started at the first place, rather than directly showing the 10th Hunger Games and directly portraying Snow's character in along, because we already know that we have spent all the 3 years hating him, hating his character, and just reading about him, how he turns out from a good person to a bad person, is not really that much fascinating. So in parting thoughts, I would just say that if you have not read the book yet, it is not that much that you're missing out on. It is a very slow book, and basically the storyline itself is not that much promising. So that is it for this review, guys. Do let me know if how the review was, and if you have not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to the channel, and I'll be meeting you in the next video.